Welcome to Conversations with Zaki Baruti, with your host, Zaki Baruti. And like always, I want to give a shout out to my biological family. What's happening? To the Universal African People's Organization family. What's going on? And to New Life Evangelistic Center family, headed by Reverend Rice. Keep up the great work. And a shout out to our cameraman, Bob. On that note, we're going to have another great show. Because in studio with me is a long time colleague of mine who've been fighting for social justice and economic empowerment of our community. And I'm speaking none other than Brother Eddie Hasan, who is a very integral part of the organization called Mokan.
Yes,
welcome
sir.
To Conversations with Zaki Baruti.
Thank you, sir.
Okay,
glad to be here with you.
All right. Eddie, when I start my programs, I always like for folks to know a little bit about the person that's sitting in your seat. So just share a little background information about who Eddie Hasan is, your experiences.
Well, Zaki, from a very young age of mine, you know, I come from a struggle, you know, back during the 60s. And basically, I was part of H. Rep. Brown, Stokely Carmichael struggle. You know, I was part of that initial movement, you know, when we talk about that movement. You know, I was part of that. I was, you know, part of, you know, when I was in high school, going to college, you know, was part of that initial movement, you know, and I'm proud of that. So from that point on, it was a struggle. I mean, we was part of integration movement. We was part of that movement, Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee. That was the name of that at that time. You know, a lot of people don't recognize that, you know, and one of my colleagues and comrades is locked up. It's H. Rep. Brown. Okay, he's still locked up today, but, you know, Stokely, he's going on, you know, but the fight continues. My good friend Eric Vickers always told me, you know, the fight continues. You know, and that was one of our close friends
right.
and comrades in this struggle. So I come from that line, and as a result of that, that's been part of what I did all my life, you know, from starting my business and struggling through that and hiring our people as I progressed in business. My whole thing right now is to being able to have economic empowerment on our people. I think that that's part of the solution. Might not be all of the solution, but that's part of the solution to be able to address the things that we're dealing with today. You know, crime in our communities, you know, the lack of being able to upward mobility, and we're talking about, you know, generational wealth. All of that is part of what we're talking about. During the time that we were talking about civil rights, okay? And that was good. That was one step of it, but it wasn't a whole step. Then we're talking about that political empowerment. That was part of it. But all of that was leading up to economic empowerment. You know, civil rights, political empowerment, supposed to get you to the table for the money. And once we get to the table for the money, now we can begin to what? Buy our freedom. You know, it was always a thing, well, do you have the money to buy your freedom? Okay, we got to be able to keep that in mind because this is all about the money these days. Okay, all about the Benjamins, I think the young people say, right? So our struggle right now is being able to access that. Economic opportunities, being able to grow our families, being able to maintain our communities and make an impact. And that's what we're talking about. And that's my fight today. I've transitioned into economic empowerment, being able to create opportunities and jobs for our people. I think that part of creating jobs, good paying jobs, get to be part of the solution to be able to reduce the crime in our community. Because when you look at crime, most of the crime is generated as a result of somebody trying to get some money. If you think about it. Okay. Very few of them is just out of just anger. Okay, it might seem like that, but at the end of it, it was about some money.
Right.
So we want to be able to help our people be able to access good paying jobs. And that's what I'm doing now is doing training. I'm out of transition now. I was for 20 years the president of Mokan. Mokan is a minority construction entity, and that's been in existence for almost 50 years now. Okay.
So with that said, and you were one of the founding members of Mokan for here in the St. Louis area, right?
That's correct.
And it originated in Kansas City,
that's
am I
correct? That's correct.
One who I got an opportunity to meet him, but
Alex Harris.
Alex Harris.
Yes.
Okay. And the purpose of Mokan, so explain the purpose of Mokan and how are you spelling Mokan?
M-O-K-A-N.
Okay.
That's Missouri, Kansas. Okay, because that was the original name that impacted Missouri, the state of Missouri, and Kansas. A lot of people don't know because at the end of that, Bob Dole, who was a senator of Kansas,
right,
was a big supporter of us being able to get this thing started back in the day. Mm-hmm. Because it was all about, it wasn't about a handout, it was a hand up when we're talking about being able to do for self and being able to create businesses, you know, African-American businesses during that time. Okay.
So Mokan originated for what central purpose then? How would you sum up?
For help building African-American business in the construction.
Okay, in the construction. So it's been over 50 years.
Close
to 50 years. How would you make an assessment of the effectiveness of Mokan in the construction industry as relates to
Very effective, being able to get people in. But the impediments and the obstacles that one faces is still there.
Okay. And okay. What are those obstacles and impediments, would you say?
We got the general contractors, big white general contractors, to play games with your bidding process, to tell you that you're always too high, pay you slow, okay? Being able to get you on a job, and when you're paying slow, you can't pay your people, you can't complete the job. So all those impediments exist, okay? So those are the kind of things that we have begun to address with legislation, okay, and demonstrations, all right? So we've been able to do that over the years, and right now I'm thankful to all of the people who you, Anthony Shaheed, my good friend Eric Vickers, who's passed on, God bless him. I'm telling you that we've been able to get some things done, okay?
Okay, then. Just for clarity's sake, and I want to deal with it on the other side of the break because we got to take a break. Break down that structure when you mentioned the big corporations and how that worked, okay? But that's on the other side of the break.
I thank God for my friend Zaki Baruti. So many times, we have been together out on the lines demonstrating against this injustice and that injustice. He's been such a part of the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. So many times Zaki Baruti and his team would join us out in front of St. Louis City Hall. I just remember the time that we stood up for a woman that had died in a jail in Richmond Heights. And as we marched all the distance from Clayton down to the St. Mary's Hospital where she'd been turned away, Zaki was with us. There are so many that are hurting at this particular time. We need to let our light shine. We need to be the salt that Christ has called us to be. I want to encourage you to join Zaki Baruti, myself, and our other partners at the New Life Evangelistic Center as we celebrate 50 years of God's faithfulness. We have a big banquet that's planned in January, many events leading up to that, many throughout next year as we celebrate the 50th anniversary of New Life Evangelistic Center. Why don't you become directly involved at this time and be a part of the planning committee? Call us at 314-421-3020. Go to www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. See all the opportunities available to you. The time has come for us to be the salt that Christ has called us to be, to let our light so shine before men and women they may see our good works and glorify our Father who is in heaven. We've desired to do that for 50 years now here at the New Life Evangelistic Center, but now we need you joining us. So please get directly involved now. I'll look forward to receiving your phone call at 314-421-3020, or hearing from you, seeing you at the planning meetings, that and much more. May God truly bless you as we move on into a new generation of direct service and advocacy.
We serve.
Welcome back to Conversations with Zaki Baruti. In studio with me is Brother Eddie Hasan, who was one of the founding members of Mokan, a very effective organization dealing with employment for our people in the field of construction, basically, right?
Yes.
And on the other side, I was going to begin—
Not just employment, also helping building black businesses.
Okay, then. Thank you for the correction.
Yes.
Going to that construction industry, I mean business, you know, there's major construction that's taking place all across this area,
yes,
as well as the infrastructure bill has just been
passed. Absolutely.
How does that work in terms of the structure? You got the gigantic or the large—
Well, you got the state. The money comes to the state for, you're talking about infrastructure,
mm-hmm.
Okay? The state then got packages and architects and engineers that put these packages together to be able to go out now to bid this stuff. So they bid these projects, and the big general contractors bid these projects. And these projects have certain kind of goals on them in terms of African-American businesses, female businesses, workforce, those kind of things. Those are the kind of things that's in place when these packages come down in different areas. Okay? So they get to be the process. So once that package come down, you begin to submit bids. General contractor submit a bid. They go out now and are supposed to do a good faith effort to be able to include African-Americans and females on these projects.
And they be as subcontractors.
They be as subcontractors.
Okay.
Absolutely. So that's the process. Okay? So we're looking for that process to be played out in terms of being able to impact African-American business, female businesses, and also a workforce that's a diversified workforce as well. So those get to be now some of the parameters that have to be met in this process. But general contractors oftentimes play games with that, okay? So those are the impediments that we are faced with in that process.
So in combating those impediments, what are some of the things that you advocate?
Well, we advocating, we want to be able to have a fair process of being able to get a job.
Mm-hmm.
I always tell people that minority participation don't necessarily mean that you're going to make some money. Oftentimes, they use minority participation to economically assassinate you because they want you to be cheap. They're gonna be slowing on paying you. So they get you on the job by meeting their quotas of participation, but don't necessarily mean it's going to be fair play in that process.
So digressing for a moment, I know one of the achievements of Mokan, which I was a participant, was, and just looking back in history, was the shutdown of Highway 70.
Yes.
Revisit that for me. Now, what was behind that, and what was the positive outcomes of the shutdown?
Well, what was behind that was real simple, was taxation without representation. That was the real simple answer to that question. Our tax dollars was going to be able to help build highways and byways coming through our community, and we was not represented in that process. We didn't have black contractors on the job. We didn't have black workers on the job. Okay, so there you are. You paying for something, but you're not receiving any benefits of it. Okay, they tell us our only benefit is you ride over the highway. Okay, but that wasn't that. We want to be able to benefit in every segment of our dollars being spent. And that's what we are today in terms of what, and we'll come back to that, but in terms of what we was able to achieve out of that was that we shut that highway down, okay? And that was an effort of the people, and that's what we got to keep in mind. The people is the power. The power is in the people that we stand up and be able to voice that in every segment of our lives, not just in construction, but in every segment of it. We can stand up and voice that and make things happen collectively. We come together collectively and we did that, okay?
And what was the outcome?
The outcome was the fact that we was able to stop that project, revisit that contract, get African-American contractors on the job and workers. In addition to that, the governor then, Mel Carnahan, bless his soul, he's gone, okay, was able to, now we was able to get to the table. Paula Carter was part of that, bless her soul, okay, to negotiate with the state, because one of the big lies that they was telling was that they couldn't find black folks who was qualified to be able to work on the projects. who had transportation, who could pass the math test, who could pass the drug test. So all that got to be their excuse for not having black folks working on a project coming down through your neighborhood. Okay? They working and we watching.
Right.
Okay? So part of that, what part of what we was able to accomplish was that we were able to now get the state to fund an initiative. We said to the state and we said to the general contractors, if you can't find them, we can. Okay? You can't find them because you're not looking. Okay? So we were able to get the state to fund, put a fund up for us to start a training program so we could go out now and recruit African Americans and women into this program, help them to be able to address the issues that they said that they was not able to find folks that would pass a drug test, that could pass a math test. So we set up a training program to address all of that, okay?
So that training program was a school.
That's right. Construction Prep Center, which we're still dealing with today under the banner of Mokan, which I run on a daily basis, okay, where we bring in, where we go out and recruit African-Americans and females into our programs, okay, where we now begin to address all of these impediments, okay, transportation. We got a connection on transportation where when they come through our program, we're able to get them connected to transportation if they don't have it, okay? We got a drug program inside of our training program where we test people coming in. We got a drug counselor if they're testing positive, okay? So we can begin to help them to address that drug issue, okay, along the way. We got math tutors. We got hands-on skills where they're able to now know what the tools and all those things are moving forward so they can be prepared when they go out there.
Okay, then. On that note, though, we got to take another quick break.
Wise men still seek him. And as we seek the Christ of Christmas, we see that he tells us that as often as we've done it to the least of these, even so we've done it unto him. Jesus said, "Fox have holes, birds have nests. See, the Son of Man had nowhere to lay his head." So we can lay our gifts before Jesus by directly helping the poor, the fatherless, the widowed, the hurting, the homeless. And the New Life Evangelistic Center offers you so many opportunities. That's why I want you to go to the website at nlecstl.org. You can follow us on Facebook. So many opportunities there. You can help on Christmas Day, whether it's in Springfield, Missouri at 806 North Jefferson, or directly in front of the 1411 Locust Building in St. Louis, Missouri. And your tax-deductible gifts make all the difference in the world to the hurting and the homeless, as we directly want to help them not only in Christmas but all year long. And it's the New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. You can send your gifts in or you can give online. As we continue to seek him, let's let his love flow in us and through us into the hurting and the homeless that are all around us.
There are so many women and children experiencing homelessness in the United States and throughout the world. You can be a part of the difference today by partnering alongside New Life Evangelistic Center and the work that they're doing to save women and children's lives who are experiencing homelessness. In St. Louis, we have safe houses where women are able to find the rest that they need and the job training and transitioning from going from homelessness to housed. You can make a difference by partnering with us financially today. Another way you can help is the women and children in India who are experiencing brokenness and hurt and pain. Donate to New Life today to make a huge difference in their lives. There are so many people who are hurting, but you can make a difference in the life of the individual today by partnering alongside New Life Evangelistic Center.
2 Corinthians 5:17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has gone, the new has come.
Welcome back to Conversations with Zaki Baruti. In studio with me is Eddie Hasan, who is one of the organizers of Mokan and is in the position currently as a job placement director.
Director, that's correct.
Okay, then.
Training and placement.
Now, in that, at one point, you were the focal point of Mokan. Who is the current executive director?
Yafet Elamine.
Okay.
Yafet Elamine is the current director. Very good. You know,
and she was a former state representative.
Former state representative.
Okay.
And just for the record, my daughter.
Oh, okay. All right. Yes, I have the greatest appreciation for her dedication to, you know, uplifting people. Now, going back in terms of the, how do you go out, how many people normally are in the class, first of all?
And we recruited as many as 25 in a class, and that's packing it. That was before COVID.
Okay.
Okay. We do 20 now, and the way we do it, we do virtual. Part of them is on virtual, and other part is in the classroom because we have to do social distance.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah. We check temperatures every day. You know, we mask up. You know, and we go through the class.
So how do you recruit people? How did you get people to come to the class?
Well, first of all, the word of mouth is working real well because of the results that we've been able to achieve. So individuals who go through our program who have gotten jobs refer people to us because now you got people in the street now to see the impact that we've been able to make on people's lives and the economic status.
Right.
Okay. So we always have more people applying for our classes than what we're able to handle. And also, we do recruitment. We go to various different job fairs and hand out flyers and do all those kind of things in the neighborhood. Okay, in the community to let people know about the program.
How long is the program?
The program is 10 weeks long.
10 weeks long.
Okay, it's 10 weeks long, and it's free. There's no money involved. And just think, you aim to now get into these trades where you don't have to pay any money. If you go to Rankin, you're going to pay. You go to a community college, you're going to pay. So this is free. All you got to do is show up and want to. Okay, we're looking for individuals who want to be able to change their lives, who want to get into construction, okay, you know, and who want to make a good living for themselves, show up every day, and we help you get there.
How long are the classes, from what time to what time?
Right now, our classes from 8 to 3.
8 to 3.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, prior to COVID, they were from 7 to 3, because those are the hours that they work on the job.
Okay.
Okay. So we want to train them to being able to get up on time.
Absolutely.
Okay. Being able to make that day.
Right.
Okay. The same thing they would do in the job. Okay.
Right.
All right. We got a process where they come in because right now, you know, a lot of our people are attached to their cell phones. Okay. We said you got to check your cell phones at the door. No cell phones. Okay. For the time you got to show up because. Right. You can't be on your cell phone on the construction because now you're distracted. Construction is very dangerous, so you got to be safe.
Right.
Okay? And you can't be on your phones. So we begin to address all of those issues in this training process. In addition to that, we get into their head because now you got to understand about being able to take orders, follow instructions, and doing what you told, okay, and getting it done.
Well, let me ask this question. Because a lot of people have concerns that if they go through a school and after getting out of school, they still can't get a job. What is the process of and your rate of success as far as getting people placed on jobs?
We got an 80% success rate, mm-hmm. okay, of getting people placed. The only time that we don't get them placed on construction is because they want to go do something else.
Okay.
Okay? But if they sincere about being in construction, they're going to get a job in construction. Especially today, the demand is so high, okay, for construction workers that right now, individuals are looking for workers.
Okay.
Okay. We can't train them fast enough.
Okay. So with that said, we got to take another break, our final break, and we'll be right back on the other side.
Yes.
As New Life Evangelistic Center works to get back into the 1411 Locust Building, it has first responders that are on the streets day after day. It's helping the hurting and homeless women and children through a wide variety of safe houses, along with homeless veterans and others that are in need, on-the-job training programs, and much more. And all of it's possible because of those of you that are supporting the work of the New Life Evangelistic Center. It's New Life Evangelistic Center that owns and operates NLEC TV, also seen on your set, on 24.2. I want to encourage you to have that app put on your phone. And as you support New Life Evangelistic Center and NLEC TV, you're also helping the Zaki Baruti Show and other programs that New Life Evangelistic Center produces. As we're working to be there when people are hurting, there's so many homeless women and children, so many people that are in need. And it's the prayers of caring people like you that make it possible for us to help each and every one of these individuals.
Hello. I'm Bernie Hayes, and I'm so proud to say that I am fully immunized. I received my COVID-19 shots, both Moderna shots, months ago, and I know so many other people who have them and know that they are safe and making their family and friends safe. If you're afraid to get the shot, just at least wear the mask. At least protect yourself and protect others around you. But it is so easy, and it is free. Please, please, I'm pleading with you to get the shot. If you have any concern about yourself or any concern about your family, it's easy, it is free, and it is so well needed. If you can't get the shot or afraid to get the shot, at least wear a mask and stay distance.
Welcome back to Conversations with Zaki Baruti. We only have 3 minutes with Brother Ed Hasan, so we want to hit rapid. You know, in the age of COVID, there's been a mandate sent down by the federal government that everybody need to be vaccinated. Are you encouraging your people to be vaccinated who go through the program? And what other kind of trainings do they have, real quick?
Well, not only encourage them to be vaccinated, they get OSHA 10. They got to have OSHA 10 to be able to get on construction.
And what
sites.
Is OSHA 10?
That's a safety training. That's safety training.
Okay.
Because you got to be safe on these jobs. HAZWOPA 40. When you get a HAZWOPA 40, and then you got a lot of projects that's taking place around the country with storms and things of that nature. That's being able to deal with hazardous waste and hazardous material. So okay. They get that training. Okay. They get confined space training, being able to go down in the ground and confined spaces. They get that training. So yes, we want them to be able to encourage them to be able to get vaccinated, because on a lot of federal projects, you're not going to be able to get on those projects unless you can show that you've been vaccinated.
Now, if anybody who's listening to our program now want to get in contact with you, how would they contact you?
They can contact us, area code 314-454-9675. That's Mokan's direct number, okay?
Repeat that again a little more slowly.
314-454-9675. Oh. That's 454-9675, okay? 4666 Natural Bridge. 4666 Natural Bridge, St. Louis, Missouri, 63115.
Now, that's on that address you just gave. That's the headquarters for Mokan?
That's the headquarters for Mokan.
Now, quickly, when you look back in terms of your training program, how many people would you say that you have been able to place?
Oh, man.
Do you keep a record of that?
Yes, we got a record of it. I don't have that record right in front of me, but we've been pretty successful at placement. Matter of fact, we're coming up on our job fair. We get contractors to come in to interview our graduating students, okay? So that's taking place real soon, okay? And I can tell you, some of our students get hired before they even graduate.
Okay.
Because the demand is so high.
Right.
We got them working right now, and the other students go through deciding what trade they want to be in, because they get an opportunity to be able to deal with several different trades, but they just have to decide which one.
We only got 1 minute. Real quick, what are some of those trades? Name me about four or five.
Electric, plumbing, laborers, carpenters, painters, cement masons, okay? Operating engineers, you know, plumbers and pipe fitters, HVAC. You know, so they get a chance to be able to decide what trade they want to go in.
That's a whole array. Well, look here.
Iron workers. Don't let me forget the iron workers.
Okay, then. Well, on that note, Brother Eddie, I pray that you continue the great work that you're doing and the continued success of Mokan. On that note, to my audience, like always, I say get involved in trying to uplift our people. We say everybody should be part of an organization. We say join the Universal African People's Organization, but join some organization as well as make sure you vote at every election. May God bless each and every one of you. Peace.